Well, it's a name I haven't heard before, girls. Euroscola. What is that about?
We had to design a leaflet.
Who was making you design, if you say you had to? where did the thing come from, Euroscola?
It's a competition run by the SELB.
Yes.
Each year, and schools enter the competition. This year, it was to create a leaflet, and we had to design our own political party and manifesto. Our teacher, Nini Eyre, told us about it, and we couldn't wait to get involved.
Yeah.
And had you two competition?
Your political party, did you get a name for it?
We actually called it E-Unique.
Ah, E-Unique.
Because it was the European Parliament.
Absolutely, so. Yeah. And did it, in the going to the Parliament, was that part and parcel of the project?
Yeah, that was the main aim of the competition.
And you were selected to go on the basis of your party?
Yeah, on the basis of our leaflet,
yeah.
We won the competition.
So the leaflet was almost the manifesto of your party, was it?
Yes, it was, yes.
So what's the manifesto of your party, tell me?
Well, our leaflet, we designed it as a laptop. So you opened it up and inside the laptop, the screen was printed on it, our manifesto. And it was just that we were a unique party.
What makes you unique?
Well, I suppose the fact that we're coming from an all-girls school. All the other schools that came were mixed schools. So we were an all-girls school, and we just thought that that would make us unique. And the whole concept of our leaflet was very unique compared to the other ones that we come up with. We came up with a few leaflets and decided to put the laptop forward as our main one, and it ended up winning the competition for us.
Yeah. So. How would your political party, if it ever came about, make a difference to our lives?
Our party was striving for equality in Europe. So really that was the main aim and basis of our entire idea, that we wanted to show that we were unique, that we had qualities that people could believe in, and that we would bring Europe forward.
Yeah. Where do you think Europe needs brought forward? Is there evidence around of high levels of inequality, do you think? Probably is, if you think of the wages being paid to our new...
It became quite evident when we were over in the European Parliament. A lot of the Eastern European countries raised that issue.
Yeah.
That compared to the Western countries, they felt there was a lot of inequality there. Yeah. So
I met a man in Dublin recently, and he said to me, he was from Poland, and he said, look, I used work in Newry, and I worked in a mushroom house, and we were paid sixpences. And this was within the last year. Can you imagine that being the case? So that's the kind of thing you were addressing.
Mm-hmm. Yes,
didn't
exactly.
Want to occur. Yeah. So Our Ladies is unique in the sense that it gives you the opportunity to reach out beyond Newry, beyond Ireland, to see the world as really your theatre of operations.
Exactly. It was an incredible experience. We're very proud to have been part of it.
Yeah. So you went to the European Parliament. What for each of you was the high point of that?
I think it was just brilliant to get the experience. You know, we've never had the opportunity to do something like that before, and to really experience what it's like to sit in the hemicycle with all these other nationalities and everything, and to hear everybody's viewpoints. And because everybody was the same age group, you know, to hear everybody's opinions on different issues and all, I think for me personally, I think that was definitely...
So you guys, when I say you guys, I mean you girls and I mean you young people, you took the place over for the day.
Yes, well, it was young people from all different nationalities, so it was definitely a brilliant experience.
Yeah. Did you feel in any sense part of the club, did you feel a camaraderie with these other young Europeans?
Yes, definitely. I mean, there was times as well where we got a bit of more free time, so we got to speak to different people, and, you know, just hearing everybody's, even when it wasn't to do with the issues that we were speaking about, just to get to know other people and all, it was really good.
Yeah, what has it done to you, to your longer-term outlook? What has it done to your hopes and dreams and aspirations? Any of you want to go to politics and go into Europe, or into continental Europe, I should say? Do you ever notice that? People will say, we're now going to Europe. Of course, we are Europe. We're not going anywhere. But the distinction is important, isn't it? Continental Europe. Would you go into Parliament, do you think?
Couldn't see myself being a politician.
Why not? Maybe we need you as a politician. You're young, you're intelligent, you've invented a party. We need you.
No, I just I don't think a politician is the right job for me. It's too much blame whenever you do something wrong.
And you've got courage. I know our ladies' girls have courage, for goodness sake. Always have courage, our ladies' girls. There's no doubt about that. So I suppose it's maybe too early to ask you what you're going to be when you grow up or when you go out of school.
I honestly have no idea. I want to go for university, hopefully, to Sheffield to do European and International Law.
Hey, you're not going far away.
Yeah.
The apple is not falling far from the tree, I tell you. You've been to Europe and you've seen some, and you still want to do it.
Yeah, but I'm not sure what I want to do after that.
Is this your final year?
Yeah.
This is the year you get to wear the long dress, or the long skirt, is it?
Yeah.
I remember the day in your school when there was ructions about the skirt. Now it's a badge of honour, isn't it?
Yeah.
I was talking to Perpetua about that, your former headmistress, within the last week, and we had a good chuckle about that, the introduction of it. And what about you? What's your hopes for the future?
Well, I don't think I'll be doing anything directly linked with the European Parliament, although I will definitely vote now. I think a lot of people, they vote in their local elections, but they don't realise that there's also the European elections to vote for as well.
Yeah.
So it's really opened my eyes to that. But regarding my future, I don't know, hopefully I will want to study dentistry, so...
Dentistry?
Yeah.
That's great.
So it's nothing really to do with the European Parliament, but...
It's a tough course,
yeah,
dentistry.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of effort has to go in there. What about yourself?
Well, I want to be a primary school teacher.
Wow.
So, yeah, that's...
You are very needed, because you are going to churn out the dentists and the scientists and the politicians and the first people to go to Mars through your excellence in primary school teaching.
Yeah, well, hopefully that's the goal.
Yeah, and you?
I want to study human biology and anatomy.
Wow, you're going to invent a new human being, I tell you. Sometimes I think we would need new human beings. Are you, as young people, are you, broadly speaking, are you optimistic for the future of our planet or otherwise? I'll take each of you again. What way do you feel about it?
Oh, definitely. I think from even attending the European Parliament, I've seen how crucial it is for voting, and we get to see
people working together.
Where they actually sit. Yeah.
You know, people working together is important, isn't it? It was Churchill who once said, talk jaw-jaw is better than war-war.
Mm-hmm, exactly.
And you've seen the evidence of that. But did you get the feeling at the Parliament that it's more than a talking shop?
Oh, it is. It's definitely teamwork. Like, the whole day we had to work in teams, didn't we?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
We had to, when we were debating issues, someone would put their point forward, and then you'd discuss it, and then you'd talk again. You'd say, oh, well, I can counter-argue that. I have another opinion.
Yeah.
So it was good to see that, and everyone working together. Also, whenever we had to put forward, we were putting forward prospective legislation.
Yes.
And that was a very good opportunity for teamwork to be shown. And
yeah. Have you politics within the school? Are you encouraged in the political political arts?
Yeah, you can take it as
an L2
subject, government and politics.
Yeah, government and politics. Mm. You get much debating, you do, of course.
Yeah, and then we also take European studies as like an extracurricular club. That's how we get involved in the Euroscol competition as well.
Yeah.
And then in European studies we, learn about the European Union and the issues that's going on.
It's a great experience for you. The nearest I got to that, I was working with Oxfam, trying to change the world as you do when you're 20. You're not 20 yet, but when you hit 20, you'll still want to change the world. But lying down in front of the King and Queen of the Netherlands in a protest at the World Food Congress in The Hague a long time ago, it's 50 years ago, for goodness sake. But I mean, it's great that you're coming forward. And you guys, are you optimistic for the future that you're seeing around you? Like, we have a planet that's been worn away by the elements, by nature. It's destroying us. So, and then people are, can we now have the Ukraine and Kiev and all of that.
I know.
We have Syria, unendingly so. Do you ever want to run away and live in a desert island, or do you feel you're going to change it?
Well, that's one of the issues we were talking about, was how to be more environmentally friendly and how to save the planet. And it was really interesting how the less developed countries had different ideas to what we would do to become more environmentally friendly. A lot of our ideas were to do with electronics and saving energy, where the simple ideas that the Eastern European countries had would be really effective over here as well.
Well, you guys have got a good handle on things. Thank you very much indeed for coming in.
Thank you.
You've been great. We're going to play a piece of music now, and then we have four of your colleagues going to speak to us as well. Okay.
Thank you.
Go well. Take care. Music, sir. Biblically, I suppose I could say, blessed am I among women. I think that's a good start. More people from our ladies, and we have Aoife, we have Dara, we have Claire 1 and Claire 2, or Claire 2 and Claire 1. That'll be very, very good. But you also were at the event. You had a great time and enjoyed it. Right, well, a quick run round of the first impressions of what occurred for you.
I think immediately walking into the hemicycle is quite daunting.
What's the hemicycle?
It is the Parliament room where everyone gathers.
Yeah. It's kind of the debating chamber.
And I was very daunted personally because I had the task of introducing our school in a language that wasn't our own.
Wow.
So as an A-level French student, I was introducing our ladies in French, and I was going in and looking at all these chairs thinking,
Oh my goodness. But immediately when the chairs filled up and you realise that everyone was in the same position as you, it wasn't any more daunting than speaking in front of the whole school. It was just other young people from across Europe, and you kind of felt like they were on your side.
So ah, that's lovely.
It wasn't too...
You were part of a family.
Yeah.
Yeah. And you?
Well, I suppose a thing that struck me was how well everyone else from different countries spoke English. And, you know, it really shocked me and surprised me. They were basically fluent in English, every other European country. And it really made me want to continue with my languages. I do A-level French as well.
Yes.
And, you know, it just opened my eyes, really. I was absolutely surprised.
And maybe a wee bit surprised that we are not as linguistically fluent as they are.
That's the thing, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, they're all learning English from their preschool.
Yeah, preschool.
And they're all absolutely...
Well, we have an Our Ladies girl who's going to be a primary school teacher. I was talking to her a minute ago, and she'll make sure that she changes that as time passes by. Claire.
Well, I've never travelled before, so it was like a completely new experience for me. I've never been on a plane or anything before.
You're joking me.
Yeah.
I think you're a sacred person because there's too many of us. We do everything now, but these are great gifts that we have to the flying and the... What was it like on the plane for a start as a first?
It's pretty scary.
Was it really?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm afraid of heights and everything.
Yeah, but you only have to look. The floor's only 2 feet away from you. You don't look out the window every day. But is it lovely to see the white? I always say there's always blue above the grey. When you go up above the clouds of grey, you see the blue sky, and that's wonderful. So the Parliament itself, tell me about that, the excitement of that.
It was really like big, and it was just really big, and it was an amazing experience.
Was it intimidating for you, or did you feel, wow, I want to get in here?
No, I felt like out of my place. Like it was.
Did you?
Yeah.
But you didn't feel out of your place at the end of it?
No.
And what was the process that changed that for you?
Probably mixing with like people from other schools and seeing that they're like at the same level as you.
Yeah. And you actually saw evidence of people of difference, traditional difference, coming more closely together.
Yes.
I'm thinking of Turks, I'm thinking of Grecian people, I'm thinking the people of Greece, I'm confused this morning, it's a Monday, the people of Greece, the people of Turkey, Cypriot people, all beginning to put aside old animosities.
Yeah.
Did you see evidence of that among the young people?
Yeah.
Yeah,
they were definitely very excited to be there. And the woman, one of the Euro girls, as they call them, like gave them a wee shout out.
Euro girls?
Yeah, they were our sort of guides for the day.
Did you not say, excuse me, Euro girl guide? I'm a Euro girl too. I'm a Northern Ireland Euro.
They got the special title. It was really noticeable that everyone sort of came together, and that was really nice to see.
Yes, yes. And your own experience?
I thought it was absolutely fantastic. Once in a lifetime.
It's no. It will not be once in a lifetime. You are only starting, I tell you.
Oh, I don't know. But I thought it was fantastic that barriers were broken down between the young people of the EU. Barriers that existed in history and currently today, everything was forgotten when we were in that room. You know, the issues that were discussed were current issues, but at the same time, there was a massive emphasis on making new friendships and working as a part of a team and sharing the experience with others. And it was fantastic to be there on the same day at the same time as all these different people from throughout the EU. That was fantastic.
Yes, yes. So you're optimistic for the future. These are people whose grandfathers and grandmothers would have been at odds with each other, even gone to war, these people. But now you've seen the swathe of young people, almost a tsunami of understanding.
Yes, absolutely. I think young people today are more tolerant of issues than others of previous years. And I think that events like EuroScala give great opportunity for young people to work together and to be able to get involved in issues that are current.
Excellent. What things do you want to change in the world you're growing up into?
I think that's sort of a million-dollar question. I could list, so many things that I want to change, but I think you've probably got to think about the things that are possible and the things that I can make a difference in. And I suppose just in communicating, the way we communicate with those around us can make a big difference on a wider scale. And that's something that I learned from the Euroscola experience, that although we were just a relatively small group of young people in comparison to everyone in the world, we still have the capacity to make a difference. And I think just working with others, everyone getting that sense of equality, and having that sense of empowerment that everyone can make a difference.
Very interesting that everything is predicated upon communication.
Yeah, definitely.
It's not me doing that. You prioritise that.
Yeah, no, I think that's what was so amazing about Euroscola, is that opportunity to communicate with other people, to communicate with those who work in the European Parliament. We were communicating with young people from down south, young people from Methody, young people from Greece, young people from the Netherlands. Me and Claire had a very creative discussion with a young girl from the Netherlands, and just having that sharing of ideas, and even though we weren't always agreeing, there's something really empowering about that, and knowing that those opportunities are available today.
Yes. Yeah, and there was a great opportunity in the Euroscola to interact with the other young people from the 28 member states. Like, we took part in the Euro quiz at lunchtime, and you had to have four members in your group that were not from your own country. So that meant that you had to go up to others and ask them to be part of your team, and then work together in order to complete the quiz. And then at the end, there was the finale of the quiz, and they all come out in hoodies and hats and all. It was great camaraderie with it.
Camaraderie, it's all good.
I think everyone at the end took a different flag to their own country's flag. So
yes,
there was a real mix in there as well, and it really just emphasised the whole togetherness of the day.
Yeah.
Everything you're saying roars at me, a beginning.
Yeah, that's true. You know, I think that, you know, there should definitely be more opportunities available to young people like Euroscola, because, you know, it really opened my eyes to the issues that we have in Europe, and, you know, there's not very many opportunities for young people like us to converse with people from all those countries. You know, they're not very commonly visited.
Yes,
as such.
Yeah.
And
but yeah, more than ever, you see, more than ever nowadays, the world is your oyster, because it's easy to fly. You Google and you get and you book it on the thing, and off you go.
Yeah, there's
going to be no stopping you now. Now you've started, you know.
Yeah, it emphasised how small the world really is.
Uh-huh.
You know.
Uh-huh. I know what you're saying. Look, I wish you well.
Thank you.
And thank you so much for coming in to me.
No,
you've been very
pleasure.
Kind. And I have a justifiable pride in our ladies, because I have a family connection with our ladies. And you're in a great school, and you're being taught to reach out across the world. We're going to play you some music now, shall we?
Yeah.